favorite 电视剧，
很精彩，帮助我动脑筋，
学到的
a lot of 小技能。
每个片子应该都有一些收获，不一样的收获。
I like to watch Adventure Time because they have lots of drawings in it, and they're usually non-fiction. Sometimes funny lessons about life, nature, friendships stick together.
Black Swan. It's more as a drama, action, and thriller. It has more actions into it, more feelings, and you also use your inner self to project it. It's very nice. Getting to know yourself better in a different manner and expressing yourself in a different way than not communicating yourself through language. And then also getting into your passion leads you your way.In life for what you want to do.
现在我已经不看了，年龄可能已经过了。
电视剧不是很常看，抖音啊是会去看一下。就是正能量，还有一些生活的小技能。
I suppose science fiction because I read them as a child. I'm gonna give a takeaway message from alternative environments that give you interesting and new outlooks and taking simple ideas, extrapolating them and put so that you can replace them back into.The real world.
我在看《权力的游戏》，最重要的一字就是团结。
Recently, I watched a documentary about gold. I have the feeling that I'm too small to make things change.
And we used to watch before the CCTV 9. CCTV 9 it was our reference because of the language. He can understand, obviously, speak Chinese
fluently.
And you had exposed to the local, obviously, news, right? Let's say from the Chinese perspective.
Yes.
Not just, obviously, international news that.Maybe it doesn't bring too much from specifically Shanghai or China. This is normal TV that the foreigners used to watch.
Drama, yes, drama. Because my wife likes it. I am a follower. Maybe it's only a way to give up from the daily life. You spend time all day long in the office, and when you go back, you don't want to think about
it. Well, TV is all fake. That's all you can make of it. For your reality TV is all set up. You'd better enjoy real life.
Just a waste of time. Too much advertisement.
The news, when they speak about some war, many children who are killed. When I see that on TV, for me it's a very good lesson. I'm happy to live in a country like France or in China.
我学到的主要是关于谈恋爱的，不能够把男生对女生的好当作理所当然的，也是要互相尊重才行。这样子才可以关系更加长久之类的。
女孩子肯定还是要独立，很多时候不能生活得太谨小慎微了，还是要坚持自己的想法，勇敢一点，大胆一点，追求自己想要的东西。
特别是她后面就腹黑的时候，特别喜欢她那样子。做人有时候不能太善良，还是要看人，要学会保护自己。
明兰为人处事，在她身上会学到蛮多，很适合在职场上或者是人情处事啊，社交方面，大家就平平淡淡就好了。
做人有时候可能要低调些，不要强出头，这应该是现在在这个社会上很重要的事情。中国宫廷剧太多了，这是需要改善的一个地方。
告诉我们，中国的原来的传统的这种礼仪应该还是传承下去的。古装戏应该是可以推广的，我喜欢古装戏的。
我要告诉我妈妈和爸爸，谢谢他们每天帮助我做我的功课最好。我也非常感谢中国人帮助我学中文，我的中文老师好久以前也帮助我了，放中文在我心里 to help me communicate。